be truthful, be honest, be the kind of person that you are, and you will simply get recommended during your SSB. Well, this is not entirely correct, because let's understand this in another context. Let's say if you were applying for a PR person's job or a public relations job, unless you are a person who's polite, who is interactive, who is warm, only then you will be found suitable for that job. Let's say you're applying for a HR person's job. So unless you are a person who is assertive, who is outgoing, who can get things done, only then you will be found suitable for the HR person's job. So similarly, even for the armed forces, there is a particular skill set which is essentially required for you to make it into the armed forces. Now, this skill set has been organized or packaged into what we call as the OLQs or the officer-like qualities. Now, once again, there is another myth about the OLQs that, you know, these are certain special qualities which God has very selectively given to a few people. So either you have it or you don't have it in you. So once again, it is not entirely correct, because these are routine qualities which all of us already have. Some of these qualities may be lying dormant in you, which need to be kind of groomed and polished and chiseled. Otherwise, all these qualities to varying degrees are already there in all of you. So what you need to understand here is that when you land up at the SSB, you need to understand what is expected out of you. So unless you know what is expected of you or out of a potential officer material, only then you will be able to align your behavior or conduct yourself in a manner which is appropriate so that you are recommended by the assessors over there. Once again, you know, I keep watching some videos on YouTube where, you know, somebody is trying to, say that so-and-so Olive Greens Institute is good for outdoors, so you could go there, and so-and-so Institute is good for psych test, so you could go there. So once again, this is not correct, because all these activities which the assessors make you do over there, these are merely tools of evaluation. These are not really academic tests that, you know, you have to perform well in that. You have to show certain tricks with the phatta and balli that you will get recommended, or, you know, you have to write your stories or WAT in a particular manner that you will get recommended, because what you write over there is going to exhibit the kind of person that you are. So let's say if somebody has taught you to write certain things in a particular manner, and actually you're not that person, so somewhere in the dossier, your true self will also get revealed, and that is what is going to get highlighted, and that is how these assessors get to know who you actually are. So it is important not to project a confused persona by picking up things from here and there and trying to see what is the best way of attempting the psych dossier, or what is the tricks to, you know, get across an out of bounds area in the GTO task. So because these are not really as important as the kind of behavior that you exhibit while these tasks are going on. So the behavior that you exhibit, from that the assessors are going to infer the kind of person that you are. So if you are coming across as a person who is desirable as far as the traits which are desired of a potential officer, naturally there is nothing stopping you from making it. So you will definitely get recommended. So it is important that you start working on what is essentially required of a potential officer, and for which you need to know where you stand today. So the kind of person that you are and what is expected out of you when you land up at the SSB, you have to reduce that gap. You have to work on yourself. And now this can only happen if you have a good power of discretion and you can easily understand what is expected and who you are, and you are able to build up on this. However, if you can't do that, then naturally you need some professional help. But it's very important not to go for training or coaching where your mind will stop thinking and you are trying to portray a person that you're actually not. So it is essential that you be honest, be truthful. That is essentially required. But you can only be honest and truthful after you become the kind of person that the SSB is looking for. And for that, you will have to first understand what is the expectations from you at the SSB. So I hope I've been able to clarify this myth about being honest during the SSB. So don't worry, most of you all are almost already there. All you have to do is work on whatever that is deficient. In fact, in my next video, I will be talking about what are these qualities which are desired of a potential officer, so that you can then start working on yourself in alignment with what we will be discussing in the next video.